Fort Myers, federal housing data proves what you can see with your own eyes. The city is highly segregated, still today. Neighbors off McGregor are predominantly white. East of the railroad tracks, it's mostly black families.
The most recent data shows more than 60% of Fort Myers' black population would have to move to white neighborhoods to truly integrate. The divide isn't just where people live. It's access to education, jobs, and opportunities. The poverty rate of black families in Lee County is double that of whites. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean shows us a new project to invest in a community long neglected.
We've had a lot of fun out here. A lot of people grew up out here.
In the heart of Dunbar sits a neighborhood known as Southward Village, public housing built back in the 60s.
It's like a graveyard now compared to how it used to be and how people are used to seeing it.
William Brown is cleaning up the area. His sister lives here, one of those still here. Most families have been recently relocated ahead of a new project. All will be soon.
To see them get tore down, it's going to hurt.
I think economically, there's just been, you know, there hasn't been a whole lot of investment.
Marcia Davis is working to change that. She's director of the Housing Authority in Fort Myers, which was awarded a $30 million grant by the federal government to transform Southward Village. The goal is to turn 199 units of public housing into 375 new mixed-income apartments. But not just that.
There's all these different facets that go along with trying to improve a community, not just us tearing down housing and building it up. I think there's more a holistic approach than just bricks and mortar now.
Here's a look. It's called the Greater Dunbar Initiative, a plan to not only reshape public housing, but the area as a whole. The school district is already rebuilding the nearby Franklin Park Elementary, and the Housing Authority is pulling in partners to bring a bank, grocery store, and more to the neighborhood.
My first thought is, wow, this is ambitious. Is it realistic?
Very much so, yes.
Desi Winter is the lead on this for the Housing Authority.
This project didn't form overnight. This is years of planning. We're not just building buildings, we're also changing lives.
But in a predominantly black community like this one, trust in government is hard to come by, has been for decades. Some locals are skeptical the plan will happen, or worry those who've lived here won't be able to afford it once it is rebuilt.
It's all about a dollar bill, and there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I don't care what, who say it, what they say, and how they say it. That's just the truth about it.
They're outdated. They're old, mold, mildewed.
That's why James Muakil, the local head of the NAACP, says this project has to happen. He's a huge supporter of replacing what's here.
It's important to see this type of stimulus come to our community, finally. Finally.
The Housing Authority says more than 150 of the future units here will be reserved for Southward Village residents, with another 40 available at a new development elsewhere.
There's a fear of being displaced. That's why we work with the Housing Authority to make sure that the rules didn't change that got them in here before.
There were 188 families when we started this process, and there's going to be 188 families that are going to be accounted for when it's all said and done.
Even still, it'll be a while before anyone returns. The project is already delayed and will take several years to complete. Plus, the rising cost of housing means the work here will cost more, too. The Housing Authority is constantly working to raise more grant money.
How confident are you that what you have laid out is going to happen?
Well, we have to make it happen. We've committed to HUD, and that we're tackling it one phase at a time.
The key, Muakil says, is for locals to be involved in the process, no matter how long it takes.
Be hopeful and stay in position to return.
Reporting local in Dunbar, I'm Evan Dean for the NBC2 Investigators.